Do you ever wish your photos were just a little bit sharper? We have so many cameras available in today's day and age, including many of the 360 cameras I talk about on my channel. And while they all have a lot of perks and good things about them, one thing that has always been lacking is sharpness and resolution. It's always been one of the biggest barriers with 360 photos due to buying cheaper consumer cameras under $1,000 that don't have the resolution and sharpness that you might like. Well, what if I told you could instantly double the image quality and sharpness of any 360 photo in a matter of seconds? I've got some good news. You can, and it's using a new software I just discovered. It's called Topaz Gigapixel AI, and it's a paid software. It costs $100. It's not cheap, but if you were able to get twice as good photos using this software, would that not be worth it? For some people, the answer is yes. When you're working professionally, you want as much image quality, resolution, sharpness as you can possibly get, and it's easy to justify paying $100 to get vastly improved image quality. And for others that are just shooting for social media, it's not as easy to justify a price like that. So regardless of which camp you might fall into, I'm going to show you this awesome software today and you can be the judge. Spoiler alert, it's seriously amazing. Okay, so they do have a trial of the software if you want to play around with it before you buy a proper license. So here I've imported a shot that was taken at the Park Hyatt here in Sydney. And this was a 360 photo taken with my Theta Z1 using the dual fisheye plugin. And I've already gone ahead and edited this image, combined all the bracketed shots together into my final result. But while it does look good already, I know we can take it to the next level yet again using this software. Okay, now here's the basic interface. It's ridiculously simple. On the left you have before, on the right you have after, and then we have a few settings here on the right hand side. What we're doing in this software is firstly sharpening, and then we're removing noise. So it's going to be really important to zoom in into the small details of this shot so we can see exactly what we're doing and what the effect is of these filters. All right, I'm going to zoom in 100%, and in real time it gives you a preview of the before and after, and without even touching anything it predicts what it thinks are the right settings for fixing this image, and straight away you're seeing a big difference between the before and after there of this wardrobe. Firstly, there's less noise and artifacts that we were seeing before, but also that straight line is looking a lot sharper. Let's have a quick look around at other areas of the shot. Now what I'm going to do is move the sliders down the bottom right hand side. We have suppress noise and remove blur. Removing blur is obviously sharpening, so you want to play around with this to see what level of sharpening looks right. Most of the time if you go all the way up to 100%, it sharpens to the best of its ability. However, it is important that you inspect every detail of your image, because sometimes over sharpening can create results that look worse than before in certain areas. Let's say the detail wasn't there before and you're trying to sharpen a really blurry image. It's going to try and predict the pixels and it couldn't get it wrong. So I'm going to move around this shot as I edit and see if this has had any negative effect anywhere by turning that sharpening all the way up. So far, it's looking great. And look at the texture on that tile. That really is incredible that it was able to pull back so much detail that simply wasn't there before. I've used sharpening in other popular softwares like Photoshop and Lightroom, but I've never seen it as good as I've seen it here inside of Topaz Gigapixel. Next, I'm going to play with the suppressed noise slider, and this does exactly what it says it does. And as you can see, it just smoothed out that light there. I mean, I think I did a pretty good job at exposing this image to begin with, but inevitably, you're going to have some issues that come up with your shots no matter how good the camera is or no matter how good your techniques are. Things like noise, things like artifacts in the image, chromatic aberration, there are so many things that you simply can't control while you're shooting, which is why using software like this later on is going to help you negate some of the bigger issues that still remain even after technically perfectly exposing your image. I really can't believe the difference between the before and after here. That is incredible. And when you think of the $99 price for this software, when that's the before and that's the after, this is such an easy investment, because it literally looks like I shot this with a much more expensive and high resolution camera. So it also means I could charge more for these shots and make my money back straight away on my very first shoot. Now I'm going to zoom out a bit so I can see it from a wider perspective and have a quick look at the rest of the shot. Overall, I think it looks great. Now there is a face refinement mode you can toggle on in case you have any faces in your images. It just adjusts the algorithm a bit so your face doesn't look funny and it doesn't remove bits of your face that shouldn't be removed. And that's it, we've edited this photo, now it's time to export. And what we're going to do now is choose our final export size. What this software also does, once it has intelligently sharpened and reduced the noise of your shots, is it then takes your images and stretches them out to a much bigger size that those sharper details can exist inside of. You've got twice the resolution, 4 times, 6 times, and then there's a custom option if, say, you want it 5 times or 3 times. But you really can get up to ridiculously big resolutions, like 32,000 by 16,000, which is way too big, and that would produce all kinds of problems later trying to upload these massive files to various platforms. And platforms like Facebook have restrictions as to how big the files can be that you're uploading. So for most 360 photos, I'd recommend choosing 2 times, because this is going to mean it actually quadruples the original size of the photo by 2 times. It means 2 times this way and 2 times this way. So it's 4 times overall as big. And that's it. I did that edit in like 60 seconds. That was really fast, really easy. So I'm going to finish it off by hitting the save button and save to the same source directory that the image was originally located. Now it exports, and check out this before and after. Gotta say, I was blown away when I first discovered this software, and as someone that mostly uses point and shoot 360 cameras, this has always been a problem for me. From now on, it's so good to know I've got this software at my disposal when I need that extra sharpness and that extra level of noise removal for professional shoots. I can now feel more confident using consumer 360 cameras for paid jobs. Especially when you combine it with one of the better ones like the Theta Z1, the image quality gets seriously impressive. And of course, you can use this software with DSLR 360s or just any photos in general. So yeah, I would strongly recommend considering Topaz Gigapixel. I've found it to be worth every cent so far. I'll put a link in the description of this video to Topaz Gigapixel AI, as well as some of the other really good Topaz softwares that I also use and recommend. I consider this software not to be an essential software. Photoshop and Lightroom are more of the essential ones because they allow you to do the bigger things like focusing on your exposure, your colors, and get the photos looking nice overall in terms of dynamic range and everything else. However, I have found the more mainstream softwares to fall a bit short when it comes to sharpening and denoising. So I consider Topaz Gigapixel to be a good nice to have software that is the icing on the cake on top of what you can do already inside of Photoshop, Lightroom, or Affinity Photo. And that's it for this video. If you want to see my entire shooting and editing workflows for great 360 photos that you can use professionally, then I've got a course called Virtual Tour Pro that covers all of that. Peace out, it's been real, and I'll catch you next time.